Hey, what's up with y'all? I've been listening to Yeet's new album 2093, Crazy, Experimental. Today I'm going to show you guys how to make a beat kind of like that with like intros, outros, different sections, digital, evil shit. So that's the type of shit I'm on, and I'm going to show you guys how I made this beat that I'm playing right now. So here's the preview. This is a pretty complicated beat. It's got an intro section, it's got kind of the first main beat section, and then there's this like little transition section and a secondary beat here for kind of like an outro. The way I started this beat off was with this basic pattern with an 808. This 808 is from the Rebirth Stash Kit by Prod Brex. It's got some crazy insane 808s on it, and I just kind of started it off with this pattern. This beat, it is 161 BPM in G sharp minor, and the 808 just plays a pretty basic 6-5-3 progression. So it's got that one semitone gap that like a bunch of Yeet songs have, including most of the 2093 songs. And over here, we just have some basic panning for when it goes around an octave. All right, so first weird thing about this beat is that I layered another 808 from that same kit. It sounds like this. But on top of that, I layered a kick. That kick is the carcass kick from Vegan's component of a lobotomy kit. And then obviously you need the snare. The snare is the artery snare from the same Vegan kit. So I got this cool little hi-hat pattern. It's basically a two-step. Just to make it a bit more unique, I cloned it and basically reversed it. The patterns kind of play off each other like this. So that's the basis for the beat. But then on top of this, I added some more elements. So this is a pretty simple sound design. By the way, Vital is a free plugin that I'd really recommend getting. It's basically Serum, but free. So basically, I turned off the oscillator and just turned on the sample, used the basic white noise. And on the LFO, I made this pattern here. I've linked that, the LFO, to the level, like the volume of the white noise. Then I got some other stuff going on here. Not many effects on this, just a filter to take out the low end, bit of reverb. And I've automated a chorus with this LFO so that it kind of spreads out while it's playing. Pause like this, and then just a bit of panning over here. So again, I turned the pan all the way to the left, then set this pattern kind of in the middle so that it's panned in the middle in these parts and then goes to one side then the other. And just last little thing here, just a pitched up 808, again from the same Rebirth kit. I've put a distortion on it, Destructor, best distortion on FL Studio. A delay with the cutoff turned down, little bit of distortion, and ping pong turned all the way up. And just a basic Valhalla reverb. And it's just playing in a very high octave as like a snare layer. Kind of like a lot of the songs on 2093, it's focused just on like a drum pattern, and then adds a bunch of like counter melodies to it. So it kind of sounds like simple, but it has a lot of elements going on in and out of it to give it this like cool futuristic moving feel. So first I started with this accent from the same Vegan kit. Sounds like this. I put in this little pluck thing over here. It sounds like this. It's just based on this basic saw, and it's just got a whole lot of LFOs. So what I did was I made this the square LFO that starts all the way at the bottom, goes all the way to the top, and I automated the coarse pitch of the sound. With when you do this kind of automation, you want to make sure you're moving in like 12s. Over here, I put 24, which is like obviously 2 times 12. It starts at the normal pitch and goes down 2 octaves. I have this sine wave automating the fine pitch. This LFO3 shape here is automating the speed of the sine wave. So at first it plays really slowly. So it's just pitch shifting up and down by a little bit slowly. And then it goes up in the amount of pitch shift. The coolest part of the sound is, again, this kind of similar shape that automates the reverb. So I've put this like pretty large reverb on it with no mix. And then this shape automates the reverb. So basically, after the octave jump, it comes in with this fat reverb. Next counter melody, promise you this one's a lot simpler. Just this lead. It's just a saw wave, and then another saw wave. This one panned all the way to the left, the other one panned a bit to the right. And oh yeah, so what I've done is I've caused it to go from a low pitch to a high pitch pretty quickly. And the way I did that was I made this short envelope that goes from the top to the bottom. I put it on the transpose in this advanced tab. And instead of making it like this, going from like the middle to the right side, which makes it go downwards in pitch, I reversed it. So it moved to the left. Now it goes upwards in pitch. So that comes in like this. All right, so now we got this little crazy melody. Let me play it here. This is another pretty complicated sound. It's got a saw wave, then another saw wave, 2 octaves up with the level all the way down. And this serves to put some FM on it. And then another higher pitch layer, which I've put onto this filter here. Just adds a lot of movement to the sound. I've put a chorus that's really strong on it, a basic multiband compressor, a delay, a really high up distortion that I've automated the mix on with this sidechain shape on the LFO. I exported that melody, reversed it. I'm pretty sure I doubled its speed. So now it sounds like this. So it sounds really weird, but I think it sounds like a cool little accent on top of the drums over here. To add more progression, I rendered out this lead over here, rendered it out, and I automated its pitch so that it kind of pitch bends a little bit in this way. And I put this counter melody on. So just this like repetitive descending lead. This lead is again, 2 saw waves. Then I've got this envelope shape over here, which automates this filter that both of these saws are set to. Put a chorus on it, delay, distortion, reverb. Then I put a lot of effects on the mixer. So a fast distortion, a reverb, and then I kind of cleaned it up with this EQ and threw this delay on it. With the ping pong turned all the way up, just to kind of widen it. And I've kind of lowered the cutoff and the level so that it doesn't get in the way of the sound, but still thickens it a bit. And then I'm just automating the pan on the sound so that it jumps from ear to ear. So with the beat, it sounds like this. So yeah, again, sounding pretty cool. Got that 2093 sound. Okay, so that is all of the first beat. And so now before I move to the second beat, I'm going to move to the intro section here. All of the 2093 songs had like these industrial, like hard intros that were like really weird and experimental. So I tried to kind of capture that energy with this. But I started with this synth that is playing basically the bass notes for the song. Sounds like this. But it's got this saw wave that's pitched an octave down that is automated by this envelope. This envelope makes it go from a high pitch to a low pitch. And this envelope one is also linked to filter one. Then we've got this kind of bass layer put to the same filter. Then we've got this really high pitch layer that's level is controlled by this envelope. So it doesn't play at the start and it's got a lot more unison. So it's kind of like a wider layer. It's got a chorus, multiband compression and a lot of distortion with a bit of filtering. Then I just threw this EQ to reduce the bass so it doesn't clash. With that, I got this sub layered. This is just a basic sub, don't need to break it down. Kind of the main interesting sound going on is this. It is basically a low-pitched square wave with this crazy staircase down LFO put onto its transpose pitch. So normally it's 24 semitones down, but this automates it to start really high and slowly go down. Sounds like this crazy glitch. I also put this envelope on it. We also have this LFO that kind of opens up the filter a bit to get rid of that gross high-pitched sound at the start. I've got the square wave that automates the level of the sound, but it only comes in at this part of the sound playing. So kind of later in, adds like this pulsing sound to it. So I basically put LFO 5, made the shape, and made it automate the frequency of this. So basically it starts off with no frequency, like a very slow frequency, so it's always loud, and then it comes in moving really quickly. And finally I've got its pan moving in the same kind of way. Effects, I've put this chorus, it's again automated by the same LFO, so the sound widens out at this part, and a distortion that kind of ducks out as the sound like opens up with the chorus. So I exported that out and made it go down an octave for this part and just repeated this beeping. And you might be able to hear, it's also got this preset. This is an experimental preset that just comes with Vital called Staggered Phrases. Then I've got the synth from Vegan's Lobotomy Kit again. Kind of goes up in pitch to build tension. We got this bass sound that reverses, kind of transitions between sections. We got this synth accent again from Vegan's Kit. So yeah, kind of serves like a riser. Have this accent over here. And that's basically the intro. It kind of plays out here. Now we've got the second section. It starts off playing like this. It's got this kind of melody pitched down an octave. The bass is removed and this new snare comes in. And just to give it this industrial feel, I've got like a bunch of notes playing, going down in velocity. And I've also put this delay on it. Now we've got this bass. It's got this low octave saw wave, and then a slightly higher octave saw wave, both of which are put onto filter one. And it meets this shape. It comes in, it doesn't like hit at the start. It's got this large chorus, it's got a compressor, distortion cranked really high up, a reverb. And now we've got this little epic lead, which kind of sounds like Mr. In-Between It's lead. That song's crazy, by the way, Mr. In-Between It. So it sounds like this. So again, all these melodies are just playing off that simple 6-5-3 bass progression. All right, so this is a saw wave with the unison turned up a bit. This shape, which kind of makes it hit a bit more at the start, and then just a huge release. So the song is like, the sound is very long. It's got some glide on it, legato enabled, one voice. It's got a chorus, compression, soft clipper turned all the way up, little EQ to kind of clean it up. This filter, which is automated by the envelope. So again, it has a bit of a pluck at the start of it. A reverb turned all the way up with a pretty big size and time, which kind of like cleans out the distortion. And then just this like really small delay, like turned down a bit, just add a bit more texture. I threw another reverb on it, another distortion on it. And again, just cleaned out the low end. And kind of continuing the Mr. In-Between It inspiration, we got this bass pluck. So we got square wave playing an octave down. Then another square wave playing an octave up. This one's got some unison on it. And its levels turned down quite a lot, but it's FMing oscillator 1 with this envelope. So it kind of plays like a pluck. Envelope's also automating the filters. And then it's just got the sub layer. Got a chorus, a compression that's like really just boosting the bass, taking out the other frequencies. A delay, a distortion cranked up a lot, and a reverb again with the bass kind of turned down. And then because I've got a sub and another bass playing throughout the song, I just took out some of the low end, and that weird intro pluck, I just kind of threw it back in there just to add a bit more like glitchiness to this part. And that's being automated in with this volume. Snare comes back in, same artery snare. And then we got more Mr. In-Between It inspiration with this kick. So it's kind of this weak kick playing just a shit ton of notes with just a reverb put on it with the low end kind of taken out of the reverb. We exported out the hi-hats from the first section and we half-timed them. So they're like half the speed, pitched down a bit, and with the reverb thrown on them. So they sound more low-key for this part. It's kind of this like slow, mean sound and outro part. And again, that same lead from right at the start of the beat playing again. And yeah, that's basically it. We've got it playing an octave down over here. Then we've got the beeping coming back in again, going from two octaves down back up to its normal pitch with the descending lead back in again, just to create this cool outro section. And there you go.